So you may have driven ICE vehicles, you must have seen a lot many EVs, but I'm sure you haven't seen solar-powered electric vehicle cars on our Indian roads, but not anymore, because there's this company which is breaking the stereotype of urban mobility. And joining us today is Mr. Deshpande, Vilas Deshpande. He's going to walk us through this technological marvel and tell us more about this car and when can it be available for the customers. So Mr. Vilas, first of all, very warm welcome.
Thank you.
Please walk us through this technological marvel. How do you guys come up with this idea that no Indian market also should have another alternate option besides EVs and hydrogen powered cars? So please go
ahead. Yes, absolutely. So what we are doing here is we are creating a new category of cars. These are city cars which are intended for traveling within the city for the short distances you need to go, but with the convenience and comfort of a car. This typically is a second or third car in the family. So it does not do the job of a family car, but then for that quick drive to work or back, or drive to the grocery store, or dropping kids to school, visiting family, this is the car. So when we started building this vehicle, we started 4 years ago. And we looked at a gap in the market that nobody is focusing on the small vehicle segment.
Correct.
Electric vehicle technology allows us now to create a very refined product which will suit that customer need very, very well.
Okay.
This car is very efficient. You can get 250 kilometers of range in one charge.
Okay.
We also have CCS2 fast charging.
Okay.
So typically for a city car, you might run somewhere and say, oh, I'm running low on my battery charge.
Correct.
What do I do? So you go to a CCS2 fast charge point, plug in for 5 minutes and get a top up of 50 kilometers.
Okay.
That's more than enough for you to do the rest of your errands, come back home. And the overnight charging is the primary means of charging a city car.
Okay.
And that happens in about 5 hours.
Okay.
Now, when we have an efficient car, we are able to build a solar panel on top.
Yeah.
This is something that has been kind of a dream for a lot of people over the years.
Yeah.
But it is only becoming reality in EVA because the vehicle is efficient. That solar panel can deliver enough power to do 10 to 12 kilometers of range every day.
Okay.
And when you think about it, that is about 3,000 kilometers over a year, which is 30% of a typical person's annual driving. So you start to make a material impact on their driving ability simply by having the car sitting in the sun.
Okay. So is it feasible to charge this car without plug and play? Can it be charged directly from the sunroof?
Yes.
Or there is a possibility, or do you have to integrate with the plug-in electricity, only then it can be charged? Or like you said, it can be driven for about 12 to 13 kilometers just by charging, just by solar power, right?
So both of these work simultaneously and independently.
Okay.
So you can charge overnight, you can charge at a CCS2 fast charging point, and the solar will continue to charge as well.
Okay.
So these all work seamlessly together. So if theoretically somebody said, I want to completely charge it by solar, they would leave it out. Obviously 10 to 12 kilometers per day, it'll keep charging.
Okay.
And then you can use the vehicle for that much. So I have friends in tier 2, tier 3 cities who don't go that long distance.
Correct.
So they are already talking about the fact that they may need to charge very little because they don't go long distances and they can park it out in their sun.
Yeah. So Mr. Vilas, generally what happens is that especially solar powered vehicles, they are considered to be a very niche product.
Correct.
So how are you guys going to be accommodating and convincing those mainstream consumers to opt for this particular product? And do you think that you can bring in to a level where affordability can be catered to the large market?
Yes, absolutely. So the solar market is indeed niche, but what we are bringing here is a new category of vehicle itself. So people are now thinking about, hey, I need something convenient to go around and go visit my friends or people in the city.
Yeah.
So creating the category is the first step.
Yeah.
The solar is just a perfect addition on top that really incentivizes people to go. The car itself is very cheap to drive. So with electricity prices currently,
correct,
it's 50 paise per kilometer.
Yeah.
So the life of the vehicle, you end up saving a lot more money than if you're driving even the smallest petrol car.
Yeah.
So it is more about a change in people's behavior and thinking that, oh, I can actually improve my life quality by having a small car.
Yeah.
And then it goes from there. And people just love the low charging cost and then the solar, which provides free charging.
My next question to you is, first of all, when can we expect this thing to run on the Indian roads?
Right.
Secondly, how affordable? I know it's too early to disclose the pricing, but can you give us a tentative idea what price positioning you are planning for this particular product, and how much affordable will it be for someone who's buying any electric vehicle for the first time?
No. So I'm happy to give you a pleasant surprise. We have already revealed the pricing at the launch today.
Oh, wow.
So we will start the pricing at 3.25 lakhs.
Wow.
And we will go up to the top end trim, which is 6 lakhs. So this is a very, it's amazing value for money, a very clear choice for a lot of people. What we are able to do in the, there are three trims with different range capacities.
Yeah.
And again, we did that deliberately because there are people who are saying, I don't even need 250 kilometers of range. Why do you want me to pay for that battery pack?
Correct.
So there are people who say, even a 100 kilometer range is fine for me. For them, they can get the 3.25 lakh car.
Yeah.
We are also offering battery as a service option here.
Mm-hmm.
So the battery subscription allows them to go down to that price.
Okay.
And pay a very low 2 rupees per kilometer on the battery pack subscription. So the affordability question and the value question is already solved. We have done that now.
Yeah.
So now the question comes is, what segment of the population would like it, right?
Yeah.
So as I said, the primary early buyers will be in the category living in cities who already have a car and who want something for convenient transport in the city.
Okay.
Then beyond that, there is a huge other market where people are thinking about, there are people in our team today who said, I don't need a car, I'm never going to buy a car.
Correct.
They are actually saying, wait, if a car is like this, I might actually buy a car.
Yeah.
So there's a huge market out there.
100%.
Senior citizens, people, kids going to college, that it's all wide open for us.
Okay. Since, perhaps this is the first solar-powered electric vehicle in our country. So, you know, just tell me about this particular technology, solar power technology. Have you adopted from any other country, or it's more, it's all of, in-house and indigenous technology that you have incorporated?
It is completely indigenous, I'm happy to tell you.
Okay.
The
made in Bharat.
It is made in Bharat. It is, actually, this solar panel is made in India for automotive applications.
Okay.
It was initially manufactured for export. But we said, hey, we can use it here.
Correct.
So we have an indigenous supply chain for this panel. It's a flexible solar panel,
okay,
which is intended for use in rough conditions, and it will not have any issues with dirt or with vibrations.
Yeah.
This is an optional piece that you can add on to any vehicle that we are selling, even at the low 3.25 lakh end.
Okay.
And it will, we will have a warranty on this as the same as what the car has.
Okay.
So we have that much confidence on the technology. It is one of the best that is available in the world right now.
Yeah.
And of course, we will only keep improving it as the years go by.
My last question to you is, since this is for the first time that we are getting to see in the Indian market, what about the affordability and after-sales service?
Yeah.
Have you guys focused on that particular part as well? Because considering those first customers,
right,
who are, you know, like you said, migrating from two-wheelers to these affordable cars, what about the after-sale service? How efficient and how affordable would that be?
It is extremely efficient and affordable to own an electric car, period. So not just EVA, but any other electric car. Electric vehicles have much less maintenance compared to a internal combustion engine car.
Yeah.
So I personally have driven electric vehicles for almost a decade.
Yeah.
And I have personal experience. There is very little maintenance. Of course, the typical wear and tear that happens on Indian roads still happens.
Yeah.
And for that, we are making sure that we'll only sell the car where we have cities with dealerships and a trained service center.
Yeah.
So we are not going to sell the car unless we have that presence in each local market.
Correct.
And then the customers should have the assurance that if they have any problems, which should really be very low in frequency, if they ever have that, they can go to that local dealership and get it solved. And they will have the parts, the training, and the ability to take care of customer concerns right there in front of them.
Okay. I think that's pretty much it, and all the very best for this amazing product.
Thank you.
And
thank
lovely
you.
Talking to you.
And please tell your viewers they can go to the website to book the car. It's
sure.
evacitycar.com.
Okay.
And we are taking pre-bookings right now. The people who book early are going to get some incentives as well.
Okay.
So we would love to see people come and join us in this revolution in mobility.
Sure. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.